do.
So I'm going to my kids now, but I want to make sure my adults hear what I'm saying. I'm talking about commitment. I'm talking about when we used to open the doors. When we weren't afraid to talk to young people. We just walked past them now. We've allowed these young people now to, we scared of them. My grandma wasn't scared of no thug. The thugs were scared of my grandmother. Some guys robbed my grandmother once. He took my grandma's pocketbook. That's what grandma called it back in the day, her pocketbook. Right, my grandma pulled, I'm not gonna tell you where, but my grandma pulled a screwdriver out. My grandma chased that little boy in the alley and got her pocketbook back. And she was a legend, she was a legend in the projects. Are you hearing what I'm saying? We gotta go in. I'm gonna move forward, but you gotta hear what I'm telling you, my whole life. I told the kid when he asked the question, what do you drive? I said, I hate to disappoint you. I know you saw me on YouTube, you watched me travel across the country. I'm sorry to disappoint you, but I drive a 2000 Suburban with 245,000 miles. I know you wanted to hear Range Rover, I know. Bugatti, I know. Maybach, I know. I mean, you wanted to hear something big, but I explained to the young man, I don't have a car note. I haven't had a car note in 6 years. I don't have a car note. Listen to what I'm saying, you better hear what I'm telling you. Listen to me closely. I've been to the dealership. I saw the Range Rover that I wanted. I went to the dealership. I asked the young, he put me in it. He didn't believe I could afford it at first. You know, he saw the cap like many of you. He judged me because he saw the cap. He thought I couldn't afford it. And I looked at the tag and when I saw the tag, I knew I could afford it. But I knew I couldn't afford the Range Rover and afford to send my students to study abroad in the summer. My kids from the hood who mama can't send them to France, but they still deserve to go, just like them other kids. They deserve to be there. Yup, you from Detroit, and your mama got laid off before, and she can't send you to Australia. Not only do students go to Australia, they get credits. They get credits to go to France. And I know you and your professor are not studying the whole time when y'all in France. I know y'all not in Italy studying the whole time. Right? My kids from the hood, from the inner city of Detroit, the west side, the east side, they deserve to go too. My babies need Mac computers. And because their mama can't afford to do it, I'm going in and I will sacrifice a Range Rover. I will drive an old beat up car so that my babies can have the resources they need to do what they need to do. It's time to go back to the day and make some sacrifices. So what, you can't eat out all the time. But if you're not eating out once a week, can help somebody else to discover a life that they've never discovered before. It's time to go in. And so I'm challenging all my leaders in this room today. I challenge you to look at your portfolio, your real portfolio. Your real portfolio. And I challenge you to look at it and ask yourself, whose life is being changed because of your existence? I Move. We just came out with a mixtape. Listen to me, I'm so excited. I told my family, I got my insurance all together. Right? Got my insurance together because I fly a lot. I like to be realistic. Got my life insurance, I got my will. I started working all my stuff out and I told my wife and my kids, I said, if I die today, I feel good. They said, Dad, what do you mean by that? I said, I got over 160 videos on YouTube and we just came out with a mixtape. If I die right now and I can never give another speech, kids can go on YouTube and be inspired. My greatest accomplishment, if I leave this earth right now, kids will still be motivated by the message that I put out right now. And like Tupac, we write about 50 things that we haven't even released yet. So once I die, my boy's gonna get busy. We got stuff we taped, it's not even out there. So like Pac, I'm gonna be around for another 5 years. You're like, how did he get on YouTube? Right? Don't worry. He dead. Nope, he's not dead. He's still here. Imagine that.